I've just started uploading my vlog for this week, which you are now watching, and for some reason the intro that I did on Monday has absolutely no sound. So to give you a little bit of insight, on Monday last week I went up to the King Street Royal Horse Artillery with a group of 8 other equine photographers from the group Small and Supercharged on Facebook, and we photographed and had a tour, and they introduced us to the horses and the soldiers, showed us exactly what goes on there, and it was an incredible day. So the little bit of intro for some reason had no sound, so I just thought I would include that, but I'm gonna pick up where I left off that does have sound, so here you go. Anyway, so when I first started this job, there were a lot of photographers that really weren't very supportive. I sort of emailed them asking for a bit of advice, and they just weren't having any of it. So it's so nice that now there's kind of this up and coming generation of photographers that are all happy to support each other and be friends and meet up. So I'm really excited about that. So I thought it would make a good vlog. But we are at the, oh, it's bright, the King's Troops barracks. And they've just gone out for their morning exercise, and they're just about to come down the road. So I'm gonna video it for you. It's really cool. We just had a little talk on exactly what they do. And here they come. Listen to that noise.
Mark about the main. What's his name?
Guinness.
Handsome.
Yeah.
You're so new with him.
Very bottom top, and it's all sort of more shiny, more or less ready for after leaving. So each of them have their own head collars, so that's their best ones, which are sort of nearly ready to go.
Hello, what is that?
We all know a horse only gets better by schooling, and it's the same for even our job. If they get schooled, they might be better at their job. Because they do get strong, they do get keen. And
yeah, imagine if they're a bit of luck on.
Thank you.
So, say hi, guys. We've been to Horse Guards Parade, and we are now eating McDonald's, although I'm being good, in Trafalgar Square. And it's very bright, and we are getting wet. That's about it, really. Morning again. I just wanted to quickly, before we move on to what we're doing today, chat to you a little bit about yesterday. It was such a nice day. I was so pleased to finally meet some of the girls that I've been chatting to online for quite a while now. I'd already met two. I've met Rose from Daydream Equine Photography, and I met Sam, whose photos I did. She's Frog and Field Photography, and I did her photo shoot a couple of years ago before she became an equine photographer. So I'd already met two of them, but the rest of them, it was so lovely to meet. There was Sean, Louise, Anna, Beth, Katie, and Katie. I think that's it. I really hope I haven't forgotten anybody, but I'll put all of their links below anyway, so you can check them all out. They're from all across the country, and it was just really nice to meet up with people who kind of get what we're doing and understand the business and are supportive, and it just shows what happens when, rather than working against each other, you all work together and you end up going for lovely days out to the King's Troop and stuff. But it's just really nice. There's a lot of old school photographers who aren't so supportive and aren't into sharing and helping one another along, and I think quite a few of us, judging from the discussions we had yesterday, have been burnt by that sort of thing. I know that I had a very frosty reception from some photographers who I will not ever name when I first started out. So it's just so nice to kind of be building this next generation who are really into helping one another and being friends. And I mean, it's just so much nicer. Why would you not be like that? It's just, we've all got to work in this industry together, so why not help one another? I am always happy to refer clients that either are too far from me or perhaps can't fit in with my schedule or my prices don't fit them. I'm always happy to refer them on to other photographers. And why wouldn't I? If they're not my clients, then they can be someone else's. And that just really, really hit home yesterday. We had such a good day. And I just wanted to thank everyone involved, really. Rose, it was her idea. Katie Mortimer, who set up the King's Troop visit for us, and her friend Lisa, who showed us round, who was an absolute star, and all the girls for just being really lovely. If you want to join the Small and Supercharged group, if you run an equine business, it's not just photographers. Actually, to be honest, it's just small businesses, really. A lot of them are equine related or country related, but there's a lot of other small businesses on there as well. Just look up Small and Supercharged on Facebook. Again, I'll put the link in the description below. And it's well worth joining. It's really supportive. It's really fun. There's a lot of really useful content in there. And that's how this all came about. So I would obviously highly recommend that. So moving on to today, I am going to try my wedding dress on, my actual wedding dress, for the first time. So that's a little bit scary and very exciting. So yeah, I thought I would video some of that. And then later on, I also have something else to show you.
Look who we've got. Finley, come here. Come here. Oh, hello. Hello. Hi. How are you feeling? Oh, so tired. How is your new house? Yeah, good. You enjoying it? And do you like the cat?
Oh.
Oh man. Well. You like, you've humped the cat? Oh, bye. Bye then.
Puppy. You need to take him out on the patio.
Are you tired? Oh dear. Oh dear.
It's a hard life.
It is. Are you permanently tired? Do my hands smell of chicken? Yummy. Hello. Hello. Oh, we've got a blurry lens.
Oh no.
What is this? What is this?
Make them go where he wants.
Taking him in the garden. Coming in.
It's a big garden for a little puppy. Coming in. He's supposed to come
over there.
Hello. Hello, Mrs. Puppy. Finley. Hello. Oh, thanks.
We got pepper stick.
Oh! She took my eye out.
Phone it too far.
This doesn't know fetch yet.
Oh, it's
so clever. Let's... No, you can't take it away though, in case you like impale yourself on it.
Like
stupid.
You look like a Tasmanian devil. Ah, what's all this? Look at all that loose skin.
Puppy, puppy.
You do.
Hello. I love that jump. It's so cute. Oh my god. Okay, he's eating the vlogging camera.
It is. It's the little jump.
I think you're not meant to eat, meant to bite people. Ah.
He's like, yeah, I'll just fall over.
Morning, it's Friday today, and I've got a shoot over Coggeshall, which is again about half an hour away. Lots of nice local shoots lately, I love that. Yeah, so I thought I would take you with me. I did a shoot on Wednesday, and I don't know how well it came out because my camera was full because I filmed so much at the King's Troop the other day, and I didn't think to clear it. So I've got a couple of tiny clips which I'm going to insert here with some photos, because it was a lovely shoot, so I just wanted to pop those in here. And then obviously I've got my shoot today, so I think it's with a little girl called Lara and her pony, so I'm gonna go and do that today. But also, can we just talk about this necklace for a second? Oh my gosh, so this came through yesterday and I opened it. It's actually a bit twisted. Hang on, let's untwist it. That's better. So this is from Hi Ho Silver, obviously, and it's a rose gold plated snaffle necklace, and I am literally in love with it. I think this is my favourite piece so far. When I got it out of the box, I was like, oh my god, I love this. And it's, again, small and subtle and cute, but so pretty. So I'm really excited about this. I'm wearing it to my shoot today.